So this battery charger was one that we used at work for years and years, just to keep a trickle charge on the battery of our backup generator. But the other day we came in and noticed that it was completely toast. And it doesn't owe us anything. It's 2012. It was cheap when we bought it, just a Canadian Tire special. But when you plug it in, absolutely nothing happens. There it is plugged in. Nothing. We bought a new one for work, and I got to throw this one out. Throw it out. Which means I'm going to see if I can figure out what died in it, and if it's easy, give it a fix. Never hurts to have a spare battery charger kicking around. It wasn't a horrible one. I mean, it had a little cooling fan on it, so it probably didn't overheat inside. It did its job. Let's just see what we got. And let's be careful. Where's the fan wire going? It's going over that way. Okay. Wow. There's a lot more going on inside there than I expected. Let's just see if the camera wants to zoom in for me here. Quite a lot going on in there. A couple of inductors, I see. What else? Those guys. Oh, 4-pin dip packages. Can you see them? Yeah. Those look like opto-isolators. What have we got down in here? Wackadiodes. A couple of fairly beefy power transistory looking things. Oh, I noticed these two caps here. That one's kind of bulgy, and this one actually looks like the vent might be split open. Is it? There's some culprits there. What else we got? Oh, that doesn't look good. I'm gonna guess, without going too much deeper, that that's where an awful lot of the problem is. Wonder what. Okay, zoom back out a bit. Just unplug that. Actually, does that fan still work? Pause for just a second here. Okay. Got that little fan. It says right in there that it is a brushless DC 12 volts. So I've got it hooked up to my little power supply here, which is, set for 12. My power supply is set for 12 volts. And just shy of 3 amps, which should be more than adequate. All right, turn it on. Fan doesn't really want to turn. Strange. Okay, so that doesn't work. That's too bad. That would have been a nice little piece of salvage. Yeah, so after seeing that blown up chip in there, which while I was paused, I looked it up, and it is, excuse me here, it is an ST brand L6562, which is a power factor correcting controller for DC power supplies. So that is the brains of the operation, obviously, but hard to be the brains of the operation when you've completely puked your guts out like that. So this video is definitely no longer a repair video. It is now a tear down and salvage. So let's see what I can get out of here. I always hate taking these bloody strain relays out. Oh! Oh, more evidence. What was that before it turned into a flaming mass? It looks like it was shaped like a resistor, I'm thinking. Does it say under the soot what it might have been? Get a little bit of extra light in here. That doesn't help. All right, let's get a bit of extra light in there. Does that help? Not really. Does it say what's down there? No. Clearly, some bad stuff has happened in there. Oh, wow. Okay. Clearly, bad things have happened. Does that look like a little blob of metal coming out the side of that capacitor? Wowzers. Okay, well, that confirms it. She's definitely a teardown. Oh, what's going on the back side of the board here? Oh, wow. So, okay, hang on here. Let's zoom that back out again. So that looks like it was the epicenter of what went wrong. That is this area down in here. Wow, that freaking baked the board. That's craziness. Okay, so obviously she's hooped. And I don't know what components are going to actually be worth salvaging out of this, if any. 2200 microfarad, or 220 microfarad, 200 volt capacitor, maybe. Fuse is still intact. Inductors probably aren't hosed. What's that over there? That is a relay. That's probably good. Other than that, power cord, some nuts and bolts. Heat sinks, I'll probably grab those. But other than that, there's not going to be an awful lot of salvage value in this thing. So, three-way switch down the front there, some nuts and bolts, rubber feet, maybe those board pillars. Yeah, not a lot of salvage value in that. That's definitely... Oh yeah, it looks like, what else do I see? Looks like there's also a bit of roasting going on down in there too, yeah. Wow. A lot of stuff got toasty warm in there. Oh! Check out that little, let me zoom right in tight here. Check out that little cap down there. He's also been traumatized by the events. Wow. This thing's a lot more fried than I initially thought. Well, I stand by my assessment. Not much worth salvaging in here. Anyway, hope that was slightly amusing. If not gory and unsettling. Thanks for watching.